All right. So, hi, Jasmeet. Hi, Santosh. I hope you guys can hear me very well, right? Jasmeet and Santosh, can you just have a look at the chat window?
Hello.
Yeah, hi. Who's this? This is So what I'll be doing, I'll be on the speaking mode, guys. I hope, just want to check with you. You guys can hear me? You all of you can actually chat across on the chat window. If you see, there is a chat window across. Can you hear me? Oh, sorry, I have done a private chat. Jasmeet, Santosh, can you guys hear me? Okay, Jasmeet, you can hear me. That's great. Santosh, can you also let me know? So we just begin in a while, guys. Guru Prasad, I believe you can also hear me, right? We're going to start our session in a while. This is all right. So this is going to be the very first session, guys, where we generally talk about what exactly Digital Marketing Paathshala is all about, what do we teach, and in our overall curriculum. Okay, you can read my message and you can read my message, but can you hear me? So I'm speaking. Can you hear me, Santosh? Just give me a moment. Hi, Guru Prasad, Jasmeet, can you help me with your introductions, guys, please? Before I begin, if you can type in the chat box, please, what exactly is your background and where do you come from? Just wanted to understand. So Guru Prasad, you're from Bangalore, and Jasmeet, from which place are you? Okay, you're from Khatiwala Tank. I'm not really sure which state is that. I'm just going to start the session and let you know what exactly we do, what sort of things we provide in terms of digital marketing. So where exactly, Jasmeet, which state do you belong from? Just a second. Yeah, thanks. So we have Santosh also joining in. Thank you so much for joining in, Santosh. So we have Santosh, Guru Prasad, and Jasmeet. Santosh, can you also just help us with your introduction? Then I'll begin with my introduction and Digital Marketing Paathshala's introduction. If you can, yeah, Guru Prasad, I know you have been attending, you have attended a couple of sessions before. That's right. And Jasmeet, what state are you from? So the voice is cracking. The internet is working fine at my end, Guru Prasad. Might be some problem at your end. All right, just let's try doing this again. So Santosh, can you help us with your introduction, please? Okay, so Jasmeet, you're from Madhya Pradesh. Okay, thank you so much. Okay, Santosh, you are also from Karnataka. That's good to know. And which particular city are you from? You're from Belgaum. Okay. Great. So let's get started. I'll just begin with my introduction, guys. Thank you so much for your introduction. What exactly is your understanding about digital marketing? Guru Prasad has already told me. He has just logged out and will log in today again. Santosh, if you can let me know what background are you from and what's your understanding of digital marketing. Jasmeet, you did tell me that you've just completed your 12th in maths. But what is your understanding about digital marketing? Can you help me know that? So you know nothing about it. Okay, no problem. And Santosh, what profession are you in and your understanding about digital marketing, please? So Santosh says you're MBA marketing and you've taken basic trainings of digital marketing, but it's only theory. All right. And from where exactly have you taken this training? From any specific institute or something? Okay, that was a specific institute. All right. Okay, fine. So let's get started, guys. I'll just start with my profile. My name is Nick Bartla. Thank you for joining in today. Like I said, my name is Nick Bartla, and I have been into digital marketing profession for the past 15 years. I'm born and brought up out of Delhi only, and I was actually in United States in Canada for the past 5 years. I've recently shifted to India. That's why my profile says Toronto, Canada. And I run a digital marketing agency, an internet marketing agency by the name of SEO Creations. So I'll start from the very beginning, what exactly we mean by internet marketing, guys. Along with this particular agency, which I own and run, I cater to plenty of small and medium businesses, clients in terms of meeting their internet marketing requirements. So it's an agency only. It's an online marketing agency, which is based out of Canada. And also we have operations in New Delhi, India. Along with holding this particular agency, I run this these trainings where I am telling you about Digital Marketing Paathshala. We at Digital Marketing Paathshala provide several courses, and one of them being the digital marketing course altogether. This is the course, guys. I hope you have seen the website altogether. This is the website, dmpaathshala.com, in case you visit this website. On the homepage, you can see the courses. The very first course, which is digital marketing course, is the one for which I'm going to give you an overall brief in terms of what exactly is this course about and what internet marketing is. So you can also go ahead and download the course curriculum, guys, from here. So like I said, you can download the course curriculum by clicking on this particular link. It'll take you to another page. Just submit your details and you can download the overall course curriculum stuff, guys. So just submit across your details, you'll get the course curriculum. I'll be using that same course curriculum to talk about the entire class right now, to talk about the entire not just the class, I mean the entire program which we would be delivering. All right. Any questions you have in terms of the brief I have given about myself and the trainings which we provide? This particular course has got a lot of modules. When we say internet marketing, there are many things which it comes under this. We use internet for so many things. We use internet for, you know, playing games, for watching movies, for watching videos, for, you know, either for finding a lot of knowledge about different stuff. So we do it for several things, right, guys? We use internet for many things. But with all that things, if you see, if you are already using Facebook, let's say, do you guys help me out in understanding? Do you see advertisements on the right-hand side of the Facebook? Have you seen that on the right-hand side when you are using Facebook? Do you see an advertisement right on over here? Right. Yes, says Santosh. Can I get an answer from each one of you? Jasmeet. And we have another person joining in by the name of CTPL. Can I know your name, please, so that I can address you? So I hope Guru Prasad, Jasmeet, Santosh, all of you have seen this, seen the advertisements on these sites. Just to name, you know, Facebook is one of them. Then we have other websites also where we, you know, where marketers go and create a lot of advertisements. All right, so you're creating, you're facing video lag. All right, I'll just make sure that you don't face video lag now. I'll be slow on that part, Guru Prasad. Hi, so your name is CTPL. Can I get to know your exact name, please? If you can, your name is Naveen. All right, Naveen, can you give a small brief to each and everyone out here? So we have done the introduction part. I'll help you to understand. So Santosh, we have Santosh from Belgaum, Karnataka. He's into already into the marketing profession. Then we have Jasmeet, who has just passed out from 12th. And she's from Madhya Pradesh. Then we have Guru Prasad, who's working in the accounts division of Infosys in Karnataka, Bangalore. And so Naveen, if you can help us with your introduction as well. And then we have Prabha also, who has joined in. So Prabha, if you, Prabha and Naveen, guys, if you can help us with your introduction also, then I'll... In terms of what background are you from and which place are you from? So Naveen, you say you're from, say you're in sales, and what part of India are you from, please? And Prabha, I believe you can also hear me. You're into software sales, okay. Right, Santosh and Guru, you guys can definitely sort of network with each other. Guys, you can network. That's the reason why I do start with overall introduction. Hi, Prabha. Prabha, just let us know what profession are you into and your understanding about digital marketing. Okay, so Naveen, you're from Lucknow, and Prabha, you say you're into customer service, all right? With which organization and which part of the India are you from? Okay, you're working for an e-commerce company from Delhi. And what e-commerce company is that? If you can help me know. Creative Gifting Solution. All right. Thank you so much for the lovely introduction, guys. I'll introduce myself again. Probably some of you might have missed it. So my name is Nick Bartla, and I am into digital marketing industry for the past 15 years. I am running my own online marketing agency, which is a Canadian-based internet marketing agency, by the name of Yo Creations. I'm also part of Canadian Marketing Association, American Marketing Association, and plenty of other, you know, digital marketing bodies which are there. Just to name, one of them is Market Motive. I have passed out from University of Toronto. I did my master's from there, and I've been trainings for quite some time. Just give me a moment. My introduction, guys, and I'll just tell you about what exactly Digital Marketing Paathshala is all about. We are into trainings of internet marketing, guys. When it comes down to internet marketing, there are many things which form a part of internet marketing. Some of you might be knowing, I believe Guru Prasad and Prabha, you are also from the e-commerce division. You might have some idea. Santosh, you are also into digital marketing division. And Naveen, I'm not really sure what's your understanding in terms of digital marketing, but I'll try to explain it from a beginner's level perspective. Why do we use internet? That's the first question which I want to explain to you. We use internet because there's a plenty of stuff available for us, whether it's for fun, entertainment, or for knowledge seeking. We use it for many, many stuff. Either we use search engines, or we use emails, or we use video sharing sites, or you know, sites where we can watch videos. We do a lot of social networking by using various websites like Twitter or Facebook. These are some of them. Is there anything else which you guys can think of? Why do we use internet? Now, just as a normal person, since it's the first session, that's why I'm taking the basics, guys. So it might appear that, you know, these are pretty basic stuff which I'm talking about. Can you guys think of any other thing besides search engines, emails, checking videos, and doing social networking to buy things, which is absolutely right, which is a sort of an online shopping? I can club that into. What else can you think of, guys? So Naveen, Jasmeet, Prabha, Santosh, can you think of any other activity which you use, which you do over the internet as just a layman, not as a marketer, but just as a layman? Social awareness. Give me an example, like, please. Like, what sort of social awareness are we talking about? For promotion, okay. Give me an example. What sort of promotion advertisement are we talking about? So if we are a business owner, then definitely we would be using internet for promotion and advertisement. Absolutely right, Santosh. Absolutely right, Prabha. Does that make sense to you, Jasmeet? Whatever we have spoken so far, why do we use internet? That is the question. That is the only basic question. If you are a student, you might have been using internet for solving your maybe your projects, or you might have been using it for fun purpose, for playing games, or for watching videos, movies, listening to audio, listening to songs. And in case, if you look at from a business perspective, guys, which most of you have said that right, Prabha, Naveen, Guru Prasad, that if you are looking at promoting a business, you are a business owner or you are a marketer where you are helping any other business professional to promote their business on the internet, that can be done. Events and things happening around us in order to promote that, that's what Naveen says. Thank you so much. Yeah, that's a right answer. Whenever we guys as a layman, when we use internet, let's say if I'm using internet to buy something for doing online shopping, or maybe to, you know, do my, let's say, complete a presentation for my client, or for, you know, submitting a project of mine if I am a student, for whatever thing, if I type in something, let's say I want to buy, I want to do shopping, I say, I write, buy iPhone 6. All right. So when I type in this query, when I'm looking to buy something, it means this is my query in my head. All right. I'll go slow because there can be a video lag also. When I am looking to buy an iPhone 6, you know, that's there in my head, guys. I will go ahead and submit that query of mine into Google search engine. Would you guys also do the same, or will you do something else? If you have to buy a phone and if you have to consult, if you have to, you know, gather information about that same product on the internet, then I possibly search engine is the most easiest way to get information. Otherwise, if you talk in the offline world, you can definitely ask your friends, your colleagues, your family members. You can visit a shop in a mall or something, and then go ahead and check for the product and ask for reviews over there. This is another thing. But if you have to check for a particular information for a particular product on online, you would take your query and submit that across on the internet. Once you submit that across, this query, guys, in internet marketing language is called a keyword, right? What does it call? So we have Tanmoy also joining in. Hi, Tanmoy. What is this called? This query, guys, which I'm typing in the Google search bar, that is called a keyword. All right. Thanks, Prabha. Once you post that across, can you see all these results which are coming over? What would you do next? If you have to buy iPhone 6, you press that keyword into the search box, then you see a lot of results right up here. What will you do with these? What is the next step which is possible? What is the possibility that you would go ahead and do that? Can I get an answer from you? So I'm looking for an answer to, we will check any one option. That's right. Thanks, Prabha. And which option would you, mostly the uppermost one, right? Click on the relevant keywords, click on the relevant search result. What I will say, Santosh, these are the search results, right? So once you have posted this keyword, this is a keyword. And these are search results, guys. This is the first search result, second, third, fourth. And like Prabha said, that we will click on any of these options, and these options are called search results, guys. And you, like Prabha said, mostly the uppermost one, we probably might end up clicking on the Amazon one, which is on the top, or the Apple one, or maybe the third, which is the My Smart Price one, or maybe the fourth one, which would be the Snapdeal one, right? Jasmeet says, we will visit the site and get the info. Absolutely right, Jasmeet. And what site would that be? The, like Prabha has mentioned, the chances are that we would visit the topmost site. I think all of you agree to that. You will visit to the topmost site. These topmost sites which are there, if you see the three topmost search results, I hope all of you have got that this is a topmost search result. This is a topmost search result. Then this is the second search result, guys. Then My Smart Price is on the third search result. And fourth one is the Snapdeal one, which is the search result. All right. So once you do that, as a buyer, if you're looking to buy iPhone 6, Amazon is on the top. The chances of you buying from Amazon is very high because it's ranking on the top. Then chances of you buying from the second search result, which is Apple, or the third, and then on the fourth, that diminishes. You know, Amazon would take the lead, and Amazon might get the sale in this kind of scenario. If you guys want to be internet marketers, right? If you guys want to be internet marketers, then you will always want your client or your website to be on the top, right? You can get your website on the top, guys, with the help of Google AdWords. This is one of the products through which you can make your website rank on the top for a specific keyword by having your website appear as an ad. Can you see the first three search results, guys, are there with the help of this ad button? The ad button, the ad yellow icon is there. The ad icon with the yellow. These are the paid listings, guys. The top three ones are the paid listings. When I say paid listings, you always have to pay to Google to get your website onto the top. And the way you pay to Google is on every click, end customer will click on these search ads. You will have to always pay on every click. Let's say daily, five people are clicking, typing this keyword and getting this search result on the top. All right. Those five people are clicking every time. Yeah. Those five people who are clicking over here, they are actually going to that website, and Amazon is paying to Google for every click. For those, let's say one click was for 100 rupees. One click was for 100 rupees. And now Amazon has ended up paying 500 rupees, because 100 into 5 clicks is 500 rupees. You get on the top of the search results, whether it's Amazon or Apple or My Smart Price, they are paying to Google for being on the top. And the way they're paying is for every click. They're not paying by just placing their ad. Right? Makes sense. And on the third one, if you see the Snapdeal one is a non-paid one. Does anybody of you understand the paid ads and the paid search listings and the non-paid search listings? Right. Yeah, that's what we are talking about. Santosh says yes. All right. All right. So these are the paid listings, guys, which is also called PPC ads, pay per click ads. Right. And the one which you can see, Snapdeal or underneath Snapdeal, these are the SEO listing, guys. When I say SEO, SEO stands for search engine optimization. Over here, you are not paying to Google at all. Yes, Google AdWords and PPC ads are same. All right, guys, are we clear on that part? Jasmeet, Naveen. All right, so Jasmeet, Naveen, you've got that. I believe Santosh, Prabha, you are also okay. Naveen, okay, Naveen, you have already answered, right? So Prabha, Guru Prasad, I believe you've also understood the paid part and the non-paid part. Are you clear on that? Then I'll go ahead and explain more stuff to you. Yes, says Prabha. All right. Yes, says Guru Prasad. All right. Thanks, guys. So when I take this particular, so these are, you know, two ways through which one advertiser or one business person can get his or her website on the top. Either we get our website on the top by paying to Google, or we get our website on the top with the help of SEO listings. Two ways. There are two ways to promote and get your website on the top. One is the paid way, and the other way All right, so one is the paid way and the other one is the non-paid. So these are two different skill sets, guys. This is done. The paid ads are built by every business person with the help of one of the product called Google AdWords. Google AdWords is one of the product which Google provides to business owners or to advertisers who wants to run ads on the search engine page. And this AdWords, guys, is one of the product. We have various other products by Google, like Google Search Engine, Google Translate, Google Maps, or you have Gmail, you have Google Drive. Can you name some more Google products, guys, which Google has given you? Google Analytics, right, Guru Prasad? Anything else? The Play Store, the Google Plus, absolutely right, Santosh, Guru Prasad. Jasmeet, can you think of any? Prabha, can you think of any other? Naveen, any other product which Google provides? Google Voice Search, absolutely right, Jasmeet. All right. So this is what we will be covering in our session, guys, in our entire program, in our entire course. How can we build ads, these search ads or the paid ads, for a particular website? What are the overall measures, policies which Google has in order to get the website on the top, right? Make sense, guys? Similarly, then you have the search engine optimization. The search engine optimization over here, there are different skill sets to it. How do you get your website on the top? Digital marketing comprises 70% of this stuff. If someone wants to promote their website, major budget is either spent on these ads, guys, or on these search engine optimization listings. Other way through which you can get your website promoted is with the help of banner ads. I hope most of you have seen banner ads, guys, on various other websites. The picture ads, you can say, or, you know, the moving animated ads, right? Right. Yes, says Prabha. Yes, says Guru Prasad. If you see, this is my website. If I'll give you this URL, guys, to download the course curriculum from here, you can download the course curriculum from here. I can show you, this is one of the ads which this particular website, boontoon.com, has placed. How boontoon.com got onto my website, we will be teaching you all that as well. These are called display ads, guys. Why are these called display ads? Because you are creating an image and then you placing across on the various other websites through which you can, you know, showcase a lot of stuff. You can promote a lot of stuff. Make sense? These are display ads, guys. So we will cover the search ads. We will cover the display ads. We will cover the search engine optimization stuff also, on how that is being done across. And then, do you guys also get a lot of emailers in your inbox which are promotional emailers? Can you help me in knowing what sort of emails have you received so far which really targets you and asks you to, you know, buy stuff, or, you know, which are promotional emailers? Any company which you can think of which sends you quite a lot of emails? Emails from Flipkart, says Santosh. All right. What else? Right. Thanks. Santosh says Paytm. All right. Naveen, Guru Prasad, Jasmeet, Prabha. Naveen says Book My Show. Right. Guru Prasad says Amazon. All right. Yeah. Jasmeet, do you come across any? Prabha, do you come across any? Guru Prasad says Shop Clues. Absolutely right. Are you guys with me? Jasmeet and Prabha, are you guys listening? All right. Yeah. So Prabha says mostly from most of the company we visit. Absolutely right. And that is, I'll tell you, when we visit a particular website and that say from same website we get the advertisements, that's called remarketing. We'll be teaching that also, Prabha. Jasmeet, do you also come across these emailers? Absolutely, means we log in. Yeah. Whichever websites you log in, they show you the ads. Right, Jasmeet. All right. So when we subscribe the newsletter, absolutely, they send you across that. So this is part of email marketing, guys. What sort of emailers should we send across, on which day, on what time should the emailers be sent across? There are many dynamics to it. There are many policies to it. We will be teaching you that as well. Why are we trying to learn internet marketing? Why are we trying to learn how to make advertisements on, these search ads, these banner ads, these search engine optimization, and I'll talk about remarketing also. Why are we trying to do this? I first of all want to understand from each one of you, Naveen, Guru Prasad, Jasmeet, Prabha, Santosh, what is the reason behind doing that? Behind learning this stuff? What is your purpose for learning this? Why should I teach you? What is your objective which I can help you meet? I know I have taken your introduction, but I'm just trying to connect. Do you guys want to work with an internet marketing agency? Do you guys want to work in the marketing department of any company, or do you want to work for yourself? So Guru Prasad says to enter the digital marketing world. All right, got your point, Guru Prasad. Jasmeet, Prabha, Santosh, Naveen. If you guys can also help me in knowing that. So Naveen also says, would enter the digital marketing world. Yes, to get its knowledge. So once you get the knowledge, you also want to get into that, right? You want to work for yourself, Prabha. All right. Got your point. Makes sense. So once you want to, guys, you guys want to get into the digital marketing world, either you want to start your own agency, you want to work for any other agency, it's very important for you to know all these dynamics in terms of how search ads are made, how display ads are made, how emailers should be made and sent across. All right. So Jasmeet says to work under any other. All right. And Santosh, you want to start digital marketing campaigns for your company. All right. Great. So with all your objectives, guys, I can surely help you, and we can definitely go ahead and meet all the objectives which you guys are talking about. So with this particular program, we would start with, so today it's just an overview, guys. We will get into the depth of each and everything. We will start with understanding what digital marketing is, you know, the overall overview. Then we'll study what type of websites are there. So, you know, how do you, so different type of websites, and what sort of website would you plan? How would you plan a website and create it? So I'll even showcase, creating a website of yours, even if you are not from a technical background, guys. So we would be giving you one free website also, which is going to be absolutely your personal website. Let me give you an example of how your website is going to look like. So I'll show you one of the website, which is of one of my student only. So when I say a free website, I will give you a domain, hosting, and also a WordPress theme. All in all, these kind of websites are actually somewhere close to, 15 to 18,000 rupees. That's the cost, but we'll be giving you for free. If you can see, these are sort of an online resume sites. You can do search engine optimization for your website using this. You can also run advertisements for the website, which we will be giving you for free. And you can also run display ads, remarketing, which I'm going to talk about. You can see this particular student of mine has entered everything in terms of the skill sets she has, whether, she got SEO, Google AdWords, on page, all the other stuff, her overall, whatever she has covered so far, whatever she has learned, the education stuff, her projects, her overall, contact details and all that. You can even call her and ask her for taking references. In case you guys want references of how we have, what students are talking about Digital Marketing Paathshala, guys, you can surely write Digital Marketing Paathshala on Google, and then you can see almost somewhere close to 75 reviews, and these are all, real reviews, guys. We haven't forced anyone to write something which we want. That's their personal opinion, which they have shared. You can contact any one of them and then take reviews from them. All right. So coming back to the overall course curriculum, guys, we will start with digital marketing overview, website planning and creation. Then we'll move on to search engine optimization. Like I told you, search engine optimization is the way through which you get the non-paid listing up. You're right. How you get your website on the top of the search engine results without paying Google. Then we will talk about, guys, PPC advertising, which is through Google AdWords only. These two topics are going to be the major time takers, guys. Search engine optimization and PPC advertising. These will be practical classes where you would be working on your own websites. I will give you assignments and I'll give you work to do in terms of your website first, your personal website, which I'll give you. The keyword analysis, the search engine optimization, the overall PPC creation would need to be done across by you on your website so that you're not working on any client's website and doing any blunder on that. Once you get your hands dirty with your website, then you can jump on and work on different other websites, guys. If you will have good results to show with your website, then definitely clients wherever you will go for interview, they will value that, right? And in case you perform well with my particular agency, which is Your Creation, I get the confidence, I can give you my clients' work also to get much more experience, guys. And that has happened with various students of mine. Not every student, because every student is not same, right? So if you do a lot of good work, I can give you live projects to work on. But you have to really show that potential that yes, you have that. Once we are done with SEO and PPC, guys, we will talk about Google Analytics. Google Analytics is another product, guys, which Google provides to just digital marketers to understand the traffic on the website. How much traffic is coming onto the website, from which place, how long they have been on my website, whether they are from, Madhya Pradesh or from Uttar Pradesh or from Delhi or from Mumbai or from Bangalore or from Ludhiana or from which other place, it's like every information you get to know about that with the help of Google Analytics. Make sense, guys? I'll show you how do you configure that. How do you configure Google Analytics for your website and start, and what all things you should look on Google Analytics as a internet marketer. Once we are done with that, we'll start on with social media marketing, where we learn about YouTube, Pinterest, Facebook marketing and advertising. So, you know, the Facebook ads which are being created. Then we'll also talk about the Twitter stuff. And then after that, that's being done with respect to social media. It's very important for every internet marketer to know how to use these platforms for promotion of certain products and services. Once that's being done, then you can we would be jumping onto the email marketing, which we have already spoken about. What are the right ways to create emails? What are the right tools? How to create, you know, a contact list? From where will we get the email IDs? From where are we going to get the content for our emailers? At what time should we send it? When we have sent the emailer, how do we judge whether it was a successful campaign or a non-successful campaign? What all techniques should we look into our email campaigns? That all is going to be a part of it. Then online advertising falls under the display advertising, which I already spoken about. We'll also cover the e-commerce marketing, lead generation for business, mobile web, affiliate, AdSense, and blogging, creating digital marketing strategy, and making money as a freelancer. So I'm not getting into the depth of that at present, guys. But all in all, I hope you understand what we mean by e-commerce. E-commerce sites are those sites where we can do a money transaction and buy stuff. When I say lead generation means you are running a promotional exercise, your promotional campaign, and you are collecting responses from various people who want to buy your product, who can be your potential audience, right? Who can be your, who can buy your product. Then we have mobile web marketing, where we'll teach you how to get advertisements up on the mobile sites and the mobile apps. Within mobile apps, I hope most of you would have seen advertisements there on the top and on the, sometimes on the bottom, right? Have you guys seen such kind of advertisements, guys? I hope most of you would have. All right. Yes, says Guru Prasad. All right. Yes, says Jasmeet, Prabha. All right. Then there is another thing, guys, called affiliate marketing. This is something like, let's say I give you an example. If you guys become affiliate of Flipkart, what will happen when you become affiliate? You become a sort of a commission agent for them. If they have a particular product, let's say for 50,000 rupees, they have listed an iPhone. If you list the same product on your website, you become an affiliate. You get that sold across from your website. Then you earn a particular commission. You are somehow helping, you're somehow becoming a reseller, or you're referring, you know, you're referring any other person to the Flipkart site, and that person whom you have referred ends up buying the product. Then out of that 50,000 rupees, maybe you might get a 5% commission for yourself. Absolutely right, Guru Prasad, promoting others' product on behalf of yours. For all these things, guys, it's very important that you are good with PPC and search engine optimization. And along with, PPC, search engine, Google Analytics, social media, email, online advertising. The first section, if you talk about, you know, the third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, these are the major important ones. If you know all of them and if you try practicing for all these, then that's the way to climb up the ladder, guys. Then you can really make money out of other things. Then you can create leads. Then you can do affiliate marketing also. There is other things, guys, called AdSense and blogging. You can also make money with the help of AdSense. Now, AdSense is another new product by Google where you are not using it for promoting products, but using it for placing ads, allowing other websites to place ads on your website. Just to give you an example, This is AdSense, which I have implemented on my website. I have my website. I'm a publisher. I'm not an advertiser in this case. I've got a lot of content right up on my website over here. Whenever someone comes on my website, let's say you guys come on my website and you click on this ad, I will get money because this is my website. And on this my website, this Google has placed ads. Now, there is a particular chain to it, how Google AdSense AdWords work. I will talk about this in detail in our next session. I'll let you know when are we going to have the next session, guys. We'll talk about all these things step by step. All right. And then we will talk about how to create digital marketing strategy and how you can earn as a freelancer. And these are two, major important stuff, guys, which we'll take after we are done with these. And I'll show you live examples of how do I do for my clients. That's the most important part. I don't want to give you theoretical stuff. Theoretical stuff is something which you can even get from internet. If you guys are looking for theoretical stuff, let me tell you, this is not the channel for you to learn. This is not the place where you should invest in your time and money, because I'm a fan of teaching with the help of examples, guys. I always ask my students to create advertisements, to do search engine optimization for their personal website. Why I ask you to do it for your personal website, which I will give it to you. First of all, you are promoting yourself. Whatever efforts you are making, you're not neither making for me or for any other third party. Why should you work for free for someone? You are making for yourself. If you are making efforts, at least you are getting promoted, right? With one single thing, you are achieving dual things. Another thing is, if your website gets hurt, at least it's your website, not a live client's website. You're not at a risk. You can get your hands dirty. So I'm saying that again. If you are looking for practical things, guys, practical working, then only you will love and enjoy these sessions. Else, if you're looking just for knowledge sake, for me to just keep blabbering what exactly it is, how do you do it, if you will not put efforts from your side, then the results will never come out. If you want ROI from the money which you will invest on this course and the time, which is the most precious thing on this course, if you want return on investment, then please make sure that you give in time. Once you are done with a class every week will happen. Any questions or queries you have, we will be having a new just a second. I'll let you know the date when we are starting with a new course. That's going to be from 27th on Monday. Absolutely, Santosh. I'll be giving everything in terms of the notes, even the videos which you, sessions are getting recorded, Santosh, and I'll give you the recorded videos also for these, so that even once you are done with this course, you don't need to think that, you forgot something. You can revise in that stuff by watching that video again and again. All right. So like I said, guys, I would be giving free website. I do have certain, we'll get the same PDF. All right. I can let you know from where can you get the same PDF. If you go to this particular URL, within this, when you click on the download course curriculum, guys, it will take you to another page. Submit your details and you can get the overall course curriculum downloaded there. Right, guys, makes sense. Tanmoy, any questions? Santosh, Prabha, do you have any questions? Jasmeet, Guru Prasad, I know you have already asked me questions. Any have? Just a sec. So, August. All right. So, okay. I wanted to ask you, what time does it suit you? Weekdays or weekends are best for you? So, weekdays, we can have it like, you know, 7 to 9 p.m. or 7:30 to 9:30 p.m. on any day, whether it's Monday or Friday. So Guru, Santosh, guys, you can let me know. 7:30 to 9:30 works for you in the evening. 7:30 to 9:30 on the weekdays evening works for you. And would Friday? Okay, yeah, in evening it's fine. Santosh, if you can let me know. Guru Prasad, would weekdays be fine with you? So I'll give you both the options, guys, in terms of weekdays and weekends. If we'll have in weekdays, 8:30 to 10:30. Okay, Sunday or Saturday. Okay, let's do it that case then. I will make it 5:30 to 7:30 on Saturdays would be fine. So after, okay. Okay, so some days your office stretch up to 7:30, but Saturday would be fine with you, Guru Prasad. Yes, SEO, I'll explain in detail. You want me to, you work till 5 p.m. Okay. Okay, then let's keep it Sunday then, guys. I'll try if I can start do 5:30 to 7:30. And from which Sunday would that be? Next to next Sunday, which is 26th. Let's keep it for 26th. 6 to 8. Okay. Okay, I have another proposal. Sundays, and Sunday I said, okay, 6 to 8, then Saturdays is fine. I'm sorry for the confusion. Let me ask the last time. So Guru Prasad, Saturday 6 to 8, Jasmeet 6 to 8, Santosh, Tanmoy on Saturdays is fine. Oh, Jasmeet, for you it's not. Okay. Okay, Jasmeet, then how about Sunday then? Saturday, any other timing, Jasmeet, in the evening? Okay, let's do it Sunday then. Let's do it Sunday 6 to 8 then. That's fine. Let's do Sunday 6 to 8 p.m. and we will begin. We will start on not 19th but the 26th one. All right. Sunday 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. guys, July 26th. What I can do next Sunday in case, all right, not next Sunday, yeah, 26th. Yeah, 26th, 6 to 8 p.m. I'll ask. You guys can still come over and attend a session from the very first one and then we can take it from there. Make sense? Whatever questions or queries you have, I'm sharing across my email address. And also my number in case you want to get in touch with me on WhatsApp. I believe... Guru Prasad, you are already in touch with me on WhatsApp. Others can also get in touch with me. Santosh, Jasmeet, Tanmoy. In case you have any further queries, feel absolutely Tanmoy. We'll take PPC also in that. But there is no separate course which is just for PPC. The course charges, guys, is 7,500 for the entire course. Feel free to add me, Tanmoy. I have shared my number. It's 7,500, but as of now, we are giving it away. This is the last batch for which we are giving it for 6,000 rupees. So that's the discounted price. And this is a 3 months course, guys. So we'll have sessions on every Sunday and for 3 months, where we'll cover all these things. And the course fees total is 6,000 rupees, which is absolutely, a way too lesser price if you compare it with other people. When you compare it with other sources, I'm giving you a free website, and I'll also try to give you certain Google AdWords coupon. I'm not giving you a promise on that, but if I'll give you, okay. So Santosh, there are two installments which I can really let you do, which is 4,000 and 2,000. So 4,000 would be the initial one, Santosh, and 2,000 would be after 1 month. So that's how we have done it for others as well. Would that be fine? So Tanmoy, for PPC, we don't have a separate session. Since we are already giving this away for a lower price, that's why, we charge the full amount, and it's up to you whether you want to just attend the PPC and don't come for the SEO sessions. That's up to you. But I would always recommend you, Tanmoy, if you know SEO and you still go ahead and listen to my sessions, or you might come to know something really new. Maybe out of 10 things, 8 things might be known to you, but 2 things you might end up learning new, Tanmoy. That can happen. Right? Makes sense? All right. Thank you so much, guys. It's almost close to 4 o'clock, just 4 minutes to 4. And you're working as SEO executive. All right. So you might learn some more advanced techniques from you, Tanmoy. So guys, feel free to add me on WhatsApp. That's the best place through which you can connect with me. Just ping me over there and feel free to ask me whatever questions you get. All right. And then we'll meet on July 26th, 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. All right. See you then. Thank you so much for being part of today's session. I hope it was a valuable one, and I'll try to make it valuable for others also, for other sessions. Santosh, on 19th, where are you based out of, Santosh? Are you from Delhi? Because we are based out of Delhi. I'm based out of Delhi NCR. Okay, so you're saying online. 19th, actually, I've got certain plans on the chat. All right, I got your point. I've got certain plans for 19th. That's why I want to start it from 26th, 6 to 8. So I know it's a couple of weeks. But till then, if you have certain questions, feel free to ask me. Right, I'll give you the stuff also in terms of the overall, once you will make the payment, I'll get your website also made, and I'll push across the notes as well across to you. I'll share the payment credentials also, guys. How do you need to pay? So I can give you the bank details for that stuff. And in case you want to pay after the first session, that's also okay. So you guys can go ahead and pay after 26th, which is not a problem. I would still want you to make a decision after the second session, guys. So it's okay. That's up to you. In case you want to pay before, that's okay. Otherwise, feel free to attend the first session on 26th, and then you can go ahead and make the payment. Right? Make sense? Tanmoy, Santosh, Jasmeet, Guru Prasad. All right. Thanks, Tanmoy. Feel free to get in touch with me on WhatsApp, guys. Tanmoy, you can ping me. Santosh, Jasmeet, you can ping me on WhatsApp, guys. All right. All right. Thanks, Santosh. Thanks, Tanmoy, and thanks, Jasmeet. Thank you, Guru Prasad. Take care. Have a nice day. Bye.